gentleman is called Swami Nirmalananda. This is his picture. Now, this Swami is a very unusual Swami. You see, Sri Ramakrishna was a very unusual prophet, because most prophets at the best are enlightened and kind of sing and dance the glory of spirit and God and so on, and can inspire the rest of humanity. But there are some prophets, when they come about, they don't only just inspire us to become spiritual, they've got the power of, if you like, just by through glance or through touch, to raise us to the level of prophethood. Means not only experience God for themselves, but allow others to experience God by mere touch or mere look. And this Ramakrishna was like that. You know, so the example I use is this. You know, you heard about Parasmani, this wonderful magical thing that if you touch Parasmani to a piece of iron, the iron turns into gold.
Gold.
Wow, wonderful.
Alchemy.
Alchemy. But then, this Ramakrishna is a super Parasmani, because when he touches a piece of iron, the iron doesn't turn into gold, it turns into Parasmani too. He's got this life-transforming power. So that is why he's so important, because he can give enlightenment to others at a mere glance. And he had hundreds of people who benefited from that. But then there are 16 disciples who are considered to be central in his life story. But there was one disciple who somehow has been missed out, and that is why I'm going to talk about him. The name of this young gentleman who became one of his main disciples, I would say the son of Ramakrishna, spiritual son of Ramakrishna, his name was Tulsi. Now this Tulsi, at the age of 18, decided to kind of visit Ramakrishna, was thrilled by him and became a great devotee and a disciple, and he was enlightened by Sri Ramakrishna. Now, the word Tulsi was converted to Swami Nirmalananda by Swami Vivekananda. He recognized the character of this young man called Tulsi as being absolutely guileless. You know, this is why Nirmal is the perfect word. So he called him Swami Nirmalananda, and this guy was absolutely guileless. But there's a second definition of the word Nirmal that I think I want to focus on is this. Nirmal means you don't get it diluted. It is concentrated stuff. So this Swami Nirmalananda was exactly like that. He was such a spiritual giant that he was even prepared to transcend this marvelous order called the Ramakrishna order and start, you know, his movement in his own power, went on to Kerala and started perhaps a dozen centers there, not kind of under the umbrella of the Ramakrishna order, but if you like, under his own steam. And this is the sign of Nirmal. He is prepared to transcend the very organization that gave birth to it. And this is not a minor thing, because every organization in a way is restrictive, is prescriptive. And the most important thing Vivekananda said is, the last rule you kind of observe when you join an order is this: follow all the requirements, but the final rule should be, you should transcend all the requirements, all the laws and orders that have been imposed on you by the order. You must be able to transcend this. And one gentleman who has done this marvelous job is Swami Nirmalananda. That is why I have tremendous love for this person. You know, he flies off. He's a spirit that cannot be controlled even by order, you know, an institution. So he's prepared to fly off, you know. This is, if you like, the sign of a true, genuine spiritual giant. That is why I have tremendous love and respect for this great master called Swami Nirmalananda.